Welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. Today, we're going to talk about Dropbox. If you're in business for yourself, or even if you're just running a lot of documents on your personal computer, you've probably heard all about it. So let's dig right in. Okay, let's get into Dropbox. You probably heard about it online. You probably heard about it from your business professionals and friends. Let's discuss what it is and how does it work. Dropbox is one of my favorite platforms for sharing files, especially large files. Now, you're probably using Google Sheets and Google Docs already to share documents and files and things like that. Dropbox is a whole different animal. And this is why. Google Sheets and Google Docs and other platforms that have live sharing also have live editing, which may not always be optimal for your business. Maybe you have a PDF that you want to share, and maybe you have a large photo that you need to share, maybe you have a large file that you need to share, and you don't want to blow up your email boxes because it's too big to send, and you don't want people changing it and editing it because it's kind of set the way it is. This is where Dropbox comes in. Dropbox is a beautiful platform because it's available for your PC or your desktop or your Mac or whatever computer you're using at home or in your office. It also has a mobile version where you can share Dropbox to your phone. Now, we've talked a lot about Dropbox. Now, what actually is it? When you install Dropbox on your hard drive or on your phone, it is essentially a box, a digital box, where you can put files, documents, photographs, any file that you want to put in there. And once it's in the Dropbox, anyone that is logged in with that same Dropbox account, or you've given permission to those files, can see those files and download them to their computer. This is very, very useful when you're doing file sharing. You know, maybe you're in the photography business, or maybe you're in a marketing business and you need to share files and PDFs and everything back and forth. Dropbox is the main platform to use. Now, Dropbox is so awesome because let's say, for example, that you're in the photography business, or you're in the business of transferring any kind of photos, even if you're not a photographer, if you're a digital marketer, if you're in business for yourself and you have images, and every business works in images. So if you have those images that you need to send back and forth, Dropbox is a huge key. Think about it for Instagram, okay? Consider for a moment Instagram. Instagram is all about photography, right? If you've got great photos, you're on Instagram. That's how most photographers are sharing their images back and forth. And in fact, that's how most marketers are getting their marketing done, is through Instagram. Instagram is a new up and coming, well, it's not technically new, but it is an up and coming social media platform. I'm actually finding through a lot of social media that Facebook is becoming for the in-between generation, okay? It's not quite baby boomers, although a lot of baby boomers are using it, but it's not for the millennials either. It's kind of for that in-between crowd. So Facebook, it's a great platform, but it's not for all demographics. What people are generally using nowadays is Instagram. And if you are just taking iPhone pictures and you're not really accustomed to taking great photos with your iPhone, and that's all you're using for Instagram, this is where Dropbox comes in. So if you've got great imagery that you're capturing with your camera, throw it into your Dropbox, have Dropbox on your phone, and then you can upload directly to Instagram using Dropbox because you've got these high-res, beautiful quality images on your hard drive, and they're too big to email, so just throw them in your Dropbox, and you can use Dropbox on your mobile device to upload them directly to Instagram. Now think about it, that's just one example. You can use that through Instagram, you can use that for Facebook, you can use it for all the social media platforms that you're using to get images online. That's just one use for Dropbox. You can do the same thing with files, with things that need to be signed, with Adobe PDF files, everything that you need to transfer from one person to another or from you to yourself on a different device. Dropbox is a platform that's safe and secure to do that. Now, for example, if you've got a file in Dropbox and you need to get several eyes and hands on that file, maybe you have some students somewhere that you need to have that file printed off before they come to class, you can send that file to your Dropbox just by uploading it directly on your computer or your phone, and then share that file with a specific list of email addresses. Everyone that has that email address on that Dropbox is connected to that file. The beautiful thing about Dropbox is that you don't have to have them have access to your entire Dropbox. You can do it file specific, meaning that if you have a single file, you can send it to specific people without them having to have access to everything that's in your Dropbox account. That's part of what makes Dropbox so amazing. You can send it with a note that say, please print this off and have it at class 11 o'clock when we see you Friday. Dropbox is the most amazing platform for this because it's safe, it's secure, you can upload cool files on it, huge files on it, and it's free. One of my most favorite things about Dropbox, when you sign up for Dropbox, you're initially given this storage limit, right? Because Dropbox has got servers and they gotta pay for their space and all that. But Dropbox will also bonus you extra storage space if you share Dropbox with a new user. So share Dropbox, that way you can get more space in your storage facility for the files and things that you need to have on there. Keep in mind that you need to purge your Dropbox every now and then, especially if you are limited on space. So if you've got a document in there that you've shared with your people and you've used it in your business and you're ready to take that out of there, clean out your Dropbox. Get rid of the digital clutter. And this is a good rule of thumb to have with your emails, with your Dropbox, with your PC and your hard drive, everything, just to clear out that digital clutter. But it's really easy to remember with Dropbox because you are so limited on space. Again, download Dropbox to your phone, download Dropbox to your computer, get using that, get file sharing so you're not limited on space of files or anything like that. You're gonna love it. Okay, here's your assignment. Right now, download Dropbox on your computer, download Dropbox on your mobile device so you can start that file sharing all over the place with yourself and with your friends and family and everyone that you're working with. Hit the subscribe button and I will see you tomorrow.